вечер и добре дојдовте во најновото издание на 24 анализа. Наш гостин е Јоханес Бален, председател на Либералната интернационала и пратеник во Европскиот парламент.
Thank you. It's a pleasure to be here.
Господине Ван Бален, на само два дена пред самитот во НАТО, Македонија воопшто не е на агендата на НАТО самитот во Чикаго, бидејќи и проширувањето воопшто не, и покрај пресудата на меѓународниот суд и осудата на Грција, сепак ништо не се менува за нас.
Well, it's very painful because all the NATO members, without one, would like to see your country to be a member. And Macedonia contributes to peace operations around the world, also in Afghanistan. It's a very respected ally, and it should be able to become a member. There's only one country which is against, and as you know, it's an organization of consensus. But for the Greek Hellenic Republic, this is a bad thing because they're part of a problem and not of a solution.
Значи, ако ние сме поранешна Југословенска република Македонија, што е тогаш Грција?
Oh, I'm quite clear. You're Macedonia. That's your name. This is your country, your language, your heritage. But if you should be called Fyrom, I will call Greece the former Ottoman province of Greece because it was an province of the Ottoman Empire, but it has nothing to do with Greece today. So you were a former Republic of Yugoslavia, has nothing to do with Macedonia today. This is a non-issue. And the way the Greeks behave is contrary to their own interests. And they should stop with this harassment. You should be able to negotiate with the EU on membership. There should not be a blockade of Greece. You should become a member of NATO. There should not be a blockade. Greece has become not part of a solution, but part of the problem. That's bad for that country.
Вчера, Грција и покрај се што се случи предходно, судот во Хаг и слично, повторно Папулјас и грчките лидери седнаа на маса и рекоа доколку евентуално Македонија стане дел од агендата на НАТО самитот во Чикаго, тие повторно ќе ни стават вето. Покрај сите работи, пресудата на судот во Хаг, тие повторно го прават истото.
It is clear the International Court of Justice in The Hague has said that the name issue, which for me is not an issue, but the name issue should never block Macedonia to become a NATO member. And I say this is the same, of course, applies to the European Union. And again, that the Greek government today, Greece is an immense economic and political crisis. I would say stop with this nonsense of trying to be negative to Macedonia. Start with your own commitments to the European Union, to NATO, to the international community, to international law, and start reforming your country. Don't divert your attention. Let Macedonia be Macedonia.
Македонија во идентична позиција и за Европската Унија. Европската комисија веќе неколку години бара старт на пристапните преговори, односно препорачува за членството на Македонија во Европската Унија, но проблемот е повторно во Грција. Членката со во моментов во Европа најголем економски и политички проблем, економската криза и неформирањето на владата. И Европскиот парламент побара итен старт на преговорите, но очигледно сето ова е бадијало.
I told President Ivanov, your president whom I met, Foreign Minister Popovsky, and also Mr. Zhirinovsky, who is the leader of the party Liberal Democrats, which is my host. I've told them Greece is in big problems. In 1 month's time, they have to elect a new parliament. If that new parliament will not accept all the deals Greece has with the European Union, and with the International Monetary Fund and with the European Central Bank, all the arrangements, if it doesn't accept them, they have signed it. It's the end of Greece in the Eurozone. There can not be an alternative. They have to accept what they have agreed to. They have to start reforming. So there is only one way. And if they don't take that way forward, it's the way out. And I have already said that I don't believe that Greece has then a real future in the European Union as such, because it has then proved to be unreliable, not able to make compromises. The basis of the European Union is compromise and legality, and to solve problems. Greece is not adhering to the International Court of Justice, to international law. It's not solving and reforming their own economic problems, and it doesn't adhere to the, let me say, the contracts it has made with the international community. This is a disaster for Greece. I hope that the Greek electorate will change the situation June 17. It's my birthday then. I hope that they give me a present.
Значи, проблемот не е во принципот на консензус во НАТО и Европската Унија. Очигледно, една членка го злоупотребува овој принцип.
That's clear. I mean, consensus cannot be misused. There is no Greek national interest. Macedonia does not claim one inch of Greek territory. You have the state of Luxembourg and the province of Luxembourg in Belgium. Where is the problem? You have Brittany in France and you have Great Britain. Where is the problem? So you can have the Republic of Macedonia and you can have a province of Macedonia in Greece. What is the problem? So if Greece continues to misuse its position in NATO and EU, it will in the end cause a big conflict between all the NATO members and Greece, all the EU members and Greece. So again, it's not consensus which is the problem. The position of the Greek government is the problem. They should change this. Otherwise, I don't see a future for Greece in international organizations, including EU or NATO.
Со вакви погледи кои што навистина се редкост за еден европски политичар, барем јавно да ги искаже, претпоставувам дека не сте баш најдобро дојдени во Грција.
Well, I've been 5 times this year to Greece. Because I'm not an enemy of Greece. I would like to help sensible reform politicians like Dora Bakoyannis and others in order to become member of parliament and of government. Because I believe that in the end, the ordinary Greek salesman, citizen, he or she will pay the price. So I'm not an enemy of Greece. I'm a friend of the population of this country. And the government policies of the Greek governments are negative to the population. The situation with Macedonia is not only negative for Macedonia, it's negative for the Greek population. So I hope that the Greek population changes the political relations.
Ваш став за убиството на 5 невини млади момчиња во Македонија, добро сте запознаени со актуелната ситуација во Македонија. Според полицијата, ова е терористички акт и спроведен од радикални исламисти. Сакале ли да признаат или не европјаните, дел од нив, но ние сме биле и ќе бидеме дел од Европа. Каков е вашиот коментар, како европјаните реагираат на овие случувања во Македонија?
For me, I come from the Netherlands, from Holland. Islam is not a problem. Muslims are not a problem. But radicalism is the problem. And of course we see that there are very radical Muslims normally outside your country, outside Bosnia. This is an important problem, and I hope because we have problems ourselves also in Western Europe, they are not only problems of Macedonia, that we can able to integrate our Muslim citizens, that we should shake hands with them, because 99% of those people are not radicals. It's only a very small group. And together we should fight radicalism. So inclusion and talks and dialogue will help to single out the terrorists with help of the Muslim community. So this should be our way in Macedonia, in the Netherlands, in others. Let citizens unite irrespective of their political views, of their religion. Let citizens unite against terrorists.
Кои се вашите очекувања за Македонија? Велат дека е неблагодарно да се прогнозира, но која е вашата прогноза за Македонија? Имајќи ги предвид актуелните политички и обштествени случувања во Македонија, но и во Европската Унија.
I think that Macedonia, which is a constructive country, with a constructive opposition and government, should remain to be constructive, which means work together with the European Union to solve problems concerning media freedom, concerning the economy, ethnic problems, work with us. And we should do it now so that the period of the real negotiations will be short because you have done the homework and we have done the homework. So if things go right, it could be that within a period of, let us say, 5 years, you could be a member of the EU. the same would apply to NATO or even earlier. It could be that you find yourself into these two organizations, and unfortunately Greece could be outside of both. I don't like this, but it could be a reality.
Ви благодарам што бевте наш гостин. Ова беше господинот Ван Бален, председател на Светската интернационала и член на Европскиот парламент. Ви благодарам што бевте со нас и останете на фреквенцијата на 24 вести.
Thank you. Thank you.